Hi everyone, welcome to Finance MD. My name is Dada Rosanes. I'm one of the Executive Vice Chairman of IMG, our International Marketing Group. By profession, I'm a medical doctor, so sa clinic, sa hospital, I do medical check-up. But as one of the financial educators of IMG, financial check-up naman po yung ginagawa ko. And together with my husband, Jason, we work to share the financial literacy advocacy of IMG. For this coaching session, I'm going to share to you about Kaiser International Long-Term Healthcare. But before I give you the details about Kaiser, let me first share to you how to build a solid financial foundation. Like building a house, kailangan matibay po yung ating financial foundation. Ang isang bahay, ano, kailangan matibay yung pundasyon. Pag nagkaroon po ng lindol, baha, bagyo, hindi po agad masisira ang bahay natin kung matibay yung foundation. Ganun din po sa finances. You must build a solid financial foundation para pag nagkaroon po ng financial emergency or financial calamity, hindi naman po babagsak yung bahay natin. On top is our investment. Stock market, mutual fund, real estate, those are example of investment. So we invest to reach our financial goals. But we have to protect it. How? By creating an emergency fund. Emergency fund is at least 3 to 6 months of your expenses. Nakaset aside po ito so that pag nagkaroon po ng emergency, like mawala ng trabaho, malugi yung negosyo, may magkasakit sa pamilya, meron po tayong pagkukunan. We're not going to pull out our investment. Next is to eliminate debt. Debt is like a termite that is eating your financial house. Mas malaki po yung interest ng utang compared to your investment. Bad debt will make your investment useless. Life insurance and healthcare fund are the real foundation in building wealth. We need life insurance, especially if you are a breadwinner. Dapat insured tayo so that when something will happen to you, may maiiwan sa family. At dapat may healthcare fund din po tayo. Just imagine if a breadwinner will get sick. Hindi makakapagtrabaho, so most probably walang kikitain. Gagastos kasi kailangang magpagamot. Imagine the financial burden to a family if walang kinikita yung breadwinner and kailangang gumastos because magpapagamot. And ang pinaka-importante po is to increase your cash flow to fund our goals. Ang cash flow po ay ang perang pumapasok at lumalabas sa isang pamilya. Income minus expenses. Ano ba kadalasan ang mas malaki, yung income o yung expenses? So dapat yung income, ano? Kasi kung mas malaki pa yung expenses, mahihirapan yung isang family na mag-ipon. Nowadays, yung income natin from our first job is usually just enough to pay for the bills. If you want to save and invest, you need additional sources of income. To increase your cash flow, two things that you need to do. First is to reduce your expenses. Budgeting, kailangan po talaga natin gawin yan so that alam natin kung saan pumupunta yung kinikita natin. Pangalawa, kung talagang sobrang tipid ka na, no, kulang pa rin, you need to find additional sources of income. And like building a house, you must build it from the ground up. Unahin natin ang pag-increase ng cash flow natin to fund our goals. So let us now go to the complete financial plan. Two things can happen to a person. Either you die too soon or you live long. Both of which will put you and your family in a very challenging situation. If you die too soon, who's going to take care of your family? If you live long naman, who will take care of you? Ang solution po, if you die too soon, you need life insurance to replace the income, or it will serve as an instant money para meron tayong maiiwan sa family just in case mag-pass away agad ang breadwinner. And if you live long naman po, solution is investment and long-term care. So three major financial needs. Investment, to generate continuing income even if you are already retired. Life insurance, to protect your family if you die too soon. And healthcare, to provide you healthcare when you retire or when you stop working. So what if I could share to you a provider that has three of everything? It's called Kaiser Ultimate Health Builder. It is 3-in-1. It's a healthcare product that has an investment and insurance. So sino po ba si Kaiser? Kaiser is duly accredited with the Department of Health and is also registered with the Securities and Exchange Commission with an authorized capital stock of 160 million. Kaiser is spearheaded by one of the seasoned HMO executives and prominent doctor, its president and medical director, Dr. Lea Uyolo. Kaiser has two main products, short-term and long-term. Ang short-term po, ito yung mga yearly renewable. It could be an individual plan, family plan, group or corporate, the one that is being provided usually by our company, and the senior care plan. And for this session, we are going to discuss the Kaiser Long-Term Health Builder. It's a 7-year paying and 13 years waiting plan. Kaiser long-term healthcare is designed to provide healthcare beyond that of an HMO. Meaning, kapag ka tayo ay nag-retire na or nag-resign na, in between jobs, meron pa tayong dapat coverage. It allows an individual to save during employment while still being covered by the company's health plan. So, habang bata pa tayo, malakas pa tayo, at habang wala tayong sakit, dapat nagsisimula na tayo mag-ipon for our long-term healthcare. It is geared to address the long-term healthcare needs of individual, especially after employment and retirement years, and securing a more comfortable elderly life. So Kaiser long-term healthcare can give you peace of mind para just in case out of the employment or when you are already old and retired, hindi ka mag-alala regarding your healthcare budget. Meron kang long-term healthcare coverage. So, for our purpose, we are going to discuss the K100 plan, Ultimate Kaiser Health Builder. The K100 plan has an annual installment of 58,821 or contract price of 411,750. As I've said, Kaiser is a 7-year saving period and 13 years of waiting or extended period, total of 20 years. So, ano ba ang mga benefits ng isang Kaiser plan holder? Unahin po natin ang benefits during the saving period. Habang nag-iipon ako sa Kaiser, meron agad akong pwedeng i-enjoy na benefit. Una, annual physical exam. So, kasama po dito yung physical exam, chest x-ray, fecalysis, urinalysis, CBC, or complete blood count. And for Kaiser members ages 35 and up, kasama na din po yung ECG. And for female members above 35 years old, ECG and pap smear. Kaiser also has dental benefits. So meron pong mga unlimited dental consultation, simple tooth extraction, once a year po yung oral prophylaxis, and also recementation of jackets, crowns, inlays and onlays, and minor adjustment of dentures. Meron din pong basic medical benefits just in case ma-hospital po tayo, meron tayong coverage kung ma-ooperahan or madadala sa intensive care unit ang Kaiser policy holder. Number 4, member's choice of room and board for K100 plan is up to 1,000 pesos per day. Yearly medical benefit limit of 60,000 per year that can be enjoyed after the full payment of the first year of the total premium. Ganun din po yung annual medical, dental, and basic health benefits. It can be availed after payment of the first year of the total premium. Meron din pong term life insurance coverage and accidental death and dismemberment benefit. Ano pong ibig sabihin nun? A Kaiser policyholder is covered by term life insurance for 20 years or until the age of 75, whichever comes first. Meron pong makukuhang long-term care benefit and long-term care bonus. Ang long-term care benefit po is 100,000 and the long-term care bonus is 350,000 with a total of 450,000. Kung natural cause po yung ikakamatay ng Kaiser policyholder, 450,000 po yung benefit. Pero kung accidental death po, additional 450,000, so total of 900,000. So again, if a Kaiser policyholder, for example, dies on the third year, meron po siyang insurance na 450,000. And again, if accidental ang cause of death, doble po yun or 900,000 po yung makukuha ng beneficiary. Meron din pong waiver of membership fees due to death and waiver of membership fees due to total and permanent disability. For example, ang Kaiser policyholder dies on the third year. So kung titingnan po natin, meron pang 4th, 5th, 6th, and 7 years. Ang ibig sabihin po ng waiver of installment due to death and credit of life, yun pong remaining premium from the 4th to 7th year, hindi na po kailangan bayaran ng family. So aside from the insurance benefit na makukuha nila, hindi na rin po kailangan magbayad ng remaining premium. At kung sino po yung beneficiary, siya na po rin yung mag-e-enjoy ng health card. Next is waiver of installment due to disability. Paano, for example, na-accidente yung Kaiser cardholder? Hindi naman namatay, but permanently and totally disabled. So, once proven na totally and permanently disabled na po, hindi na po kailangan bayaran yung premium. Pero meron po tayong waiting period for 6 months. So, habang iniintay po natin yung approval, magbabayad po muna tayo. But once it is approved, refundable po yung binayad natin during the period that we are already disabled. Kaiser has also family assistance service. So, pwede pong gamitin ng ating relatives yung access natin sa Kaiser. Inuulit ko po, access ang pwede natin gamitin. Ano po yung mga guidelines? The policy should be active and the plan should have completed at least 1 year of payment. And kung sino po yung immediate family member na gagamit ay dapat nasa first degree of consanguinity ng Kaiser cardholder. So, ibig sabihin po, kung married, yung asawa, and then yung anak, kung single naman po, yung parents, and yung kapatid. Kaiser holder agrees to avail only of the services of Kaiser accredited doctors and affiliated network of hospitals. So, ibig sabihin po, dapat yung doktor na titingin at yung ospital na pagdadalahan doon sa ating kamag-anak ay accredited ng Kaiser. Assistance to be provided by Kaiser shall only be to the extent of the allowable benefits due to the plan holder under his policy. Ibig sabihin po, kung ano lang po yung limit na pwedeng i-avail ng original Kaiser policy holder, hanggang doon lang din po ang pwedeng i-avail ng ating family member. And prior to discharge of the nominated patient, payment should be settled to Kaiser. So, dapat magbabayad din po tayo sa Kaiser. So, once again, yung access lang po ang pwedeng gamitin ng ating relative so we could enjoy the discounts, but still, magbabayad po siya kasi hindi naman po siya ang original Kaiser cardholder. Kaiser approval to avail of such assistance must be first obtained by the member and the issuance of LOA will then be given. So, dapat po, bago ma-admit or once na-admit, i-inform na agad po yung Kaiser na gagamitin yung family assistance benefit. Kasi kung doon po natin i-inform yung Kaiser kapag madi-discharge na po yung patient, baka hindi na po natin magamit yung family assistance services. So please note that this assistance is an accommodation and not considered a benefit of the plan. Hence, approval and denial on the availment solely depends on Kaiser management evaluation. Next is, ano naman yung benefit ko during the extended healthcare coverage period? Meaning, doon naman ako sa 8 years to 20th year. For a K100 plan, ang una nating benefit is the 10% yearly health benefit. So, pagdating po ng 8th year, you'll be given 10% of your plan. So, nakalagay po dyan, 8th year, 9th year, 10 years, 10,000 each years, and so forth and so on. Kapag hindi po natin ito nagagamit, nag-earn po ito ng interest. For this illustration, it is being computed at 10%. So, for example, on the 8th year, you were given 10,000. Hindi mo siya nagamit. Pagdating mo ng 9th year, another 10,000. So, 21,000 na po yung value dito. Saan po galing yan? 10,000 from the 8th year plus the interest after a year. So, 10% of 10,000 is 1,000 plus the 10,000 on the 9th year total is 21,000. And of course, 33,100. Pagdating po ng 20th year, 269,750. Meron din pong yearly health bonus. This is already pre-computed or determined. Kung hindi po din ito natin nagagamit for our healthcare benefit, nag-earn din po ito ng interest. So, for example, on the 8th year, ang total niya ay 32,981. Pero pagdating po ng 9th year, it's already 48,000. Saan po galing yung 48,000? It is the 32,981 then computed at 10% interest plus the 11,793 on the 9th year total is 48,072 and so forth and so on. Pagdating po ng 20th year, that's total of 446,419. Meron din po tayong long-term care benefit na 100,000. That's the plan that you have bought. The long-term care bonus or kung sakali pong hindi magamit for hospitalization ang Kaiser Health Card, meron pong 350,000 na long-term care bonus or 85% of what you've paid during the first 7 years. Yung annual medical and dental, during the first 7 years, libre po yun. Kahit magamit po natin yun, hindi po mababawasan ng ating long-term care bonus. For example, sobrang sakitin ka every year nagagamit mo yung card, naubos mo na yung accumulated health benefits mo, naubos mo na rin yung accumulated health bonus mo, meron ka pa rin pong 100,000 because that is guaranteed. Pero just in case, very healthy, hindi mo nagagamit or kung nagkakasakit ka, yung ginagamit mo is yung healthcare mo from your company, the total maturity value is 1,166,169. Now, ano naman yung pwede kong gawin once nag-mature na yung Kaiser policy ko? Pagdating po ng long-term care period, tatlo po yung options natin. First is, withdraw the entire maturity value. Kukuhanin ko na lahat ng pera ko sa Kaiser. Pangalawa, mag-withdraw lang ako ng portion ng maturity value. Or third is, iwan ko lang yung pera ko sa Kaiser. Let's say, for example, 1.1 million ang maturity value ng Kaiser money mo, invested in a 10% vehicle, computed at 10%, that is 116,617. Let's now discuss further the settlement options once nag-mature na ang Kaiser policy mo. First is, continued health benefit with term life insurance. Kung iiwanan mo lahat ng pera mo sa Kaiser, you will be covered with term life insurance up to age 80 with at least 50% of the total health benefit but will not exceed the 2 million face amount. You're still covered with medical, meron ka pa rin mga libreng consultation, dental benefits, at kung hindi mo nagagamit yung benefits mo, nag-earn po ito ng interest because this is invested. The rate is depending on the prevailing market but with no case less than 3% per annum. Ibig sabihin, even if down yung market, ang pinakamababa na pwedeng kitain ng pera mo ay 3% per year. Next settlement option is continued health benefit with yearly increment or annual withdrawal of the yearly increment earned. Ano pong ibig sabihin nito? Every year, kinukuha mo yung pera mo. For example, 1.1 million, nag-earn po ng 10%, that's 116,000. So, kinukuha mo yung interest every year. Kapag ito pong option na ito ang pinili mo, you will still be covered with term life insurance up to age 80 with at least 25% of the total health benefit but not exceed to 1 million face amount. Covered ka pa rin ng medical, dental, plus naka-invest pa rin po yung pera mo and you will still earn depending on the market value but not less than 3%. Next is partial withdrawal up to 50% of the total health benefit. Let's say, for example, 1 million ang maturity value, kinuha mo yung 500,000, naiwan yung 500,000. Wala ka na pong coverage ng term life insurance dito, but still you are covered with medical, dental benefits. And your money is still invested, so you have the opportunity to earn, depending on the market value, but no case less than 3% per annum. And the third is full withdrawal of the total health benefit. So, kinuha mo na lahat ang pera mo. Kapag ito po yung pinili natin, of course, wala na po tayong medical coverage, wala na din po tayong insurance coverage, and wala na rin po tayong investment sa Kaiser. My suggestion is to leave your money with Kaiser, but then of course, depende sa'yo kung ano talaga yung settlement option na pipiliin mo. Let's say, for example, iniwan mo yung pera mo with Kaiser, computed at 10%, pagdating ng 60, that is 6.4 million. So, ang 10% po nito is 648,000. At pagdating naman ng 65, that's already 10.4 million. Or ang 10% po is already more than 1 million. So, you will have money working for you. But then again, it's for you to decide kung ano po yung settlement options na pipiliin mo. So, that is Kaiser Ultimate Health Builder. If you have more questions, please don't hesitate to contact me or the person who invited you. And this has been Sarayda Rosanes and I'm your Finance MD. Thank you!